we're in a sort of a golden age of biologic science if we focus on biologic science, if we focus the resources on it. The tools are there. It's now time that we wield them with wisdom to find these answers. The story began in 1983 when an LA resident by the name of David Murdoch owned the biggest cotton mill in the country in a small town called Kannapolis, North Carolina. Well, he sold it in 1983. 20 years later, the town closed down. The property was put up for auction for nothing. I mean, for a few million dollars. Well, David went back and bought it sort of out of nostalgia. So he decided that he would build a biotechnology campus. And we began to explore what was needed to do that. And we really arrived at that you really need three things to make science move forward, big science move forward. And the first thing it takes is brain power. So we endeavored to attract some big brains, and the easiest place to go harvest brains is at universities.
The Dukes and the UNC Chapel Hill, and these are rival schools. Wake Forest, all of the schools of that era, but they have massive medical centers. They're powerful research organizations. But the deal was that you can't take it home. All here, you need to move people there, you need to put resources there, or you can't get anything.
The next thing that you need after brain power is you need infrastructure. So we went out and bought fancy microscopes, electron microscopes, there's big gene synthesizers. And then the last thing that we needed was money. NIH gave money. There's this TAA, this Transportation Authorization Authority, for towns that were affected by these trade agreements. That could provide money. So all of a sudden, there were the three things necessary for researchers to do really new things. What I think is the most important thing, and what we're trying to do in North Carolina, is I want to hire 5 mathematicians, 5 physicists, and 5 zoologists, and 5 molecular biologists, because they know nothing about what each other do. But I have a feeling that really there's going to be physics in the cure for cancer. There's going to be math in it. There's going to be ways to understand population biologies and complex mathematic algorithms about how cells multiply. For the first time, I'd like to get those people working together in what we call more of a systems approach. So it's not one guy thinking that he's going to find a cure by looking at some little thing down here. This initiative will look at ways to spend that money in a focused and more thoughtful way and do things differently. It's time we do things differently.